People often say it's like elevation training mass, which is what you can even read here, that it stimulates high altitude. But at high altitude, what happens is that we have lower oxygen content. Let's say we go to 2 kilometers high altitude, and oxygen content there is about twice less than we have at sea level. And therefore, when a person trains there, the air which is inhaled has twice less oxygen. So that causes adaptation of the human body, and there is increased production of hemoglobin and some other physiological changes which take place, positive changes, so that they help to improve fitness and sport performance. But training mask, what it does, it reduces airflow due to increased resistance. So it's kind of extension of the nose. But in addition to that, when you exhale, you are going to inhale this air, which is rich in CO2, back into your lungs. That means in addition to the so-called elevation effect, effect of high altitude, the training mask also increases CO2 content. So it's both hypoxic and hypercapnic training at the same time. Therefore, training mask, in fact, is better than training at high altitude. Because there are thousands of top or elite athletes which go to high altitude in order to improve their endurance, VO2 max, and other physiological parameters, and of course so that they can perform better and win contests. But using training mask, you can do it at sea level and getting even better results due to high CO2 content. Click the link below this video to get on web pages of normalbriefing.com, where you can find more information about training mask, lifestyle factors, and other important effects and details which relates to breathing retraining.